Talk That Shit Podcast. Do you know what it is?
Hey, this ain't that, bro.
Nah, homie. That ain't this.
All right. That ain't this podcast. Y'all know what it is now. DJ, please stand up. My boy Ray Kitty. And your boy DJ. I don't know. Yay.
Y'all see how I did that shit? That nigga still push me.
That's perfect. That's perfect. Damn, bitch. Bitch, we got it.
I'm so cold, I think I'm done with ice. If I leave her, she gon' die. Well, bitch, you done with life. Okay. Man, I pull up with no knives. I bring guns and fights. So you got this sack, I got this sack. But ain't no one to mine. My little bitch say I'm getting too cool. I don't even like dubs in mine. All right, I look like what I was doing. Them hoes like, how I'm coming. Yeah, I look like what I was doing. How I look having all these hoes. When I crack my white like gold.
That ain't this.
I know what it is. That ain't this. DJ, please. Let him know. Ray, get it. Let him know.
Yeah.
All right, then. DJ, I don't know. We up in there, baby. Huh. Yes. Episode 13. Shout out to J. Cole. Snowing the bluff.
She strike me as somebody blessed enough to grow up in conscious environment.
Bitch, erase some of this shit. You can't have no
matter. We would love to play more, but they be trying to shut us down. So we can only play so much, you know what I'm saying?
Happy Juneteenth, everybody.
June 19th. Yeah, that's the day, right? I don't fucking know, boy. He waited till it jumped off to do that.
All right, what the fuck?
He don't have sense, man.
Anyway, show must go on, so let it go. We back again, episode 13, y'all.
On Juneteenth.
Happy Juneteenth for everybody.
For everybody that celebrated, you know what I'm saying? That's pretty much everybody now.
Well, yeah, it's becoming a national holiday, apparently. Or they working on it.
It's cool to be black now.
Hell no.
I mean, it was always cool to be black, but now
it's getting cooler, by
these older white people, you know what I'm saying? Like, they be, you know. So, yeah, Juneteenth. I'm glad people celebrated and rocking with it. You should have been doing that. You waited till we got started to do that, man. You're so unprofessional.
Yeah, I apologize.
It's because you got that shirt. I should have expected nothing, he says, this is my nothing boy, more.
This my, he said, is this so for the John shirt?
Glad to be American.
Yeah, I'm just glad to be an
American. Oh, on Juneteenth.
On Juneteenth. I'm black American.
Ooh, for real.
This nigga is crazy. Yeah, but welcome back. We appreciate y'all for checking in, tuning in. You know, appreciate the comments, the likes, the unlikes. All the subscriptions, you know what I'm saying? We fuck with everybody. Thank you. We mixed it up this time, y'all. No Tito's. Oh, yeah. They know what it is.
ENJ. Wrong. Tito.
It's not no ENJ or no
A&B. Let them think we doing that, man.
What, let them think we doing ENJ?
Hell yeah.
You said no, like it's crack.
You think we're doing crack,
is
man?
Is it not that? Is ENJ not crack? Right, come on now. Sorry, get your Juneteenth off, my man.
But no, you know,
and your,
that was J. Cole. That was J. Cole, Snow on the Bluff. That's a new song. And, you know, of course, J. Cole always come with the fire. But apparently, you know, some controversy around this song. Mm-hmm. Got something to do with, like, so her name is No Name.
Yes, which is crazy.
Which fucks me up. Because they was like, it was No Name. I ain't know.
It's like a double entendre or something like that.
I mean, clearly. Like, DJ Please. Like,
what was that other nigga name? No ID?
DJ Please. Play that song.
Yeah.
nigga, no name.
You digress.
That's all I'm saying.
Let's keep it rolling.
Yep, so. What about
June?
No.
Strong arm.
So hard as hell.
Yeah, talk, so bitch.
With the controversy is with the young lady, a young rapper by the name of No Name.
Oh, so she a rapper?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would say she, I don't think it's just all rap.
Okay, so.
But I'm not sure.
She do music.
I recently just heard her do it.
She do
I'm
music.
Not sure. Yeah, but I didn't get a chance to really.
I look it up. I just didn't know.
Yeah, so she basically was saying that a lot of number one, top 10, your favorite rapper is not with the cause right now. They not tweeting nothing. They not saying nothing about what's going on. We need them to stand up. J. Cole felt like, indirectly, she was talking about him because, let y'all tell it, he the man for us. He our woke, you know, preacher and who gonna set it off for us. And so he had a little song came out saying that, you know, he's not informed and he's not as intelligent as her or however he put it. He just don't know the facts all the way. And so instead of, you know, bringing him down, how about you help him? Strong black sister, and he was just saying, like, you know, he was just saying he don't got all the answers. Something sort of like what Dave Chappelle was saying, you know, at a time like this, who wants to hear from Dave Chappelle? You know, that's what Dave Chappelle was saying when Don Lemon attacked him. But basically, yeah, so J. Cole felt a certain way saying, like, I'm with the cause, I'm with our people, but I'm not sure what to actually say. I don't know the facts, and I don't know how to, you know, help this revolution. So
that's pretty much what you got out of listening to it.
Yeah, I mean, basically that's what I got
from listening to it. Like, I agree with a lot of what you were saying, but, you know, I listened to it a couple times, and I'm like, I'm not exactly sure because I didn't really hear what J. Cole had to say other than the song. But listening to the song, It seemed like he was speaking for rappers and not just himself. You know what I'm saying? Like, he spoke on the fact. He was
that's
touching on the fact.
Like, I like that way.
Yeah, you talking to me because I feel like I'm that nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm the top of rap game.
Yeah.
I'm the one you expecting to say something because I didn't say nothing. You talking about me, but
so, yeah, he
she didn't name way. Him and he didn't name her. Nobody. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's like, it ain't necessarily. He was just talking about himself. You know, he could have been answering that for everybody she was talking about because he's not that only person. You know, he ain't the only one at the top of the
room. No, he not.
So,
no, and then, you know, clearly the public expects more from him from because of his music and then the fact that, you know, the last go around all this shit, you know, he was out there. Remember, and it was all like.
Because he made music for the woke person. So you would. I guess the woke people would think he's the one to lead us.
Do you say that? Like, maybe just the white woke people like his music, but he just make his.
What did I say? I'm not
being
funny.
He make it for
music
woke people.
For woke people.
Okay, yeah, you're right. Maybe.
But what if woke people just like his music?
It could be that woke people just like his music. I'll take that. You know what I'm saying?
They like, if
call the backpackers.
If he ain't nowhere saying that, on an interview, you know, saying something.
Like, all his music was
right, woke. Right.
But so they like it.
So I mean, we might just be fucked with our own stereotype in our brain. Like, you know, he fits the woke person. He fits the look. What he talk about?
What's woke then? We gotta answer that with woke.
I mean, woke is
what I niggas.
Don't ask me.
People who seem to understand the black plight and see that it's another, like, it's, I don't know.
Conspiracy theories.
I mean, no, I wouldn't call them conspiracy theorists. I think that Sisyphus. But I just feel like
you heard it here first.
Cause I got a friend who is woke. Like, I kind of put him on. What was them books? What was that dude? Not colorblind. What the fuck was that show called? I mean, that one.
Colorful.
No, that internet.
Oh, I don't know.
What's the name?
I know what these niggas talking about.
Super black
Tyreek,
man.
Tyreek.
Super black man.
But yeah, I put him on him, and after that, he called himself something like that.
We're
gonna put the facts on
that's
there.
That's what you get for putting him on there. Putting him on that.
It is my fault. It definitely is. Because now he a roster and everything. Oh, I shouldn't say that. I'm out.
I'm out. I don't fuck none of that shit. You know,
that's where I'm at.
You know how I feel.
I should have said.
You know how I feel.
But I don't know. That's a good question. What
I hate getting preached to. They started preaching when I was locked up. I forgot. I'm not gonna get into it.
No,
but niggas was preaching. I'm like, nobody want to hear this preaching that shit in jail.
Yeah, I feel you on that. Nobody want to be force fed nothing. Honestly. Yeah,
but to answer your question about what I think woke is, me personally, I don't think there's no clear cut
definition of
woke. Yeah, because everybody defines it so. Because most people who subscribe to being woke subscribe to different things.
Right.
I'm woke because
this is why I'm woke, and it could be something totally different what this nigga thinks.
Yeah, so it just,
so yeah, I feel you on that.
So
best I can do
is say self-awareness.
Hey, it's
self-awareness.
Alert different to injustice in society, especially racism. So some shit I've been to my whole life.
It's somebody who's more in tune with the black plight.
Well, no, some people be trying to
see, that ain't the aspect that a lot of people. Just
because I've been woke.
Clear cut definition. Mm-hmm. It ain't,
and I've been woke. So you know all them other people been extra.
He's crazy as hell.
I understand all of this shit. I'm not about to go around trying to take every conversation to the white man. Like, no, nigga, for what?
I got white friends.
What I'm just saying. All of my endeavors with most of these people, they get to talking and it be stemming like white people just the worst motherfuckers in the world. It's like, no, not mine. I know who you talking about, but not mine. And there's some terrible niggas out here too.
Okay.
So what you mean? So that's just my stance.
So let's stay on topic though. The whole J.
You ain't been woke this whole time? You ain't know whites get better shit. They got better opportunities.
It's more to it than just about.
No, you just
like white though.
They say especially racist.
I mean, that's just what they
say. Alert to injustice.
They don't get to define what it means for me. Like, you
know. Oh, yeah, man. That's when you get to walking around
with some type of definition
scarf,
of woke.
A Lauryn Hill scarf, doing this all the fucking time.
Because there's a lot of woke people doing a lot.
J. Cole, No Name. What side do you agree with? Is it a side to pick? How do you feel?
I don't think
it's
really a side to pick, only because the nigga.
Do you think she was wrong? Because I mean, not to cut you off, but I don't think she was wrong for trying to say we need more people to speak up, because we definitely need more people to speak up. That's why I was proud of Lil Baby having that song. You know, Lil Baby said, I mean, that song was beautiful.
She was wrong.
YG. I mean, we don't
think she was wrong because she said a name who the fuck she was talking about. I don't like that.
I mean, she said your top favorite, the top rappers or some shit. I can't remember exactly, but she basically.
But mine is different than yours.
Don't
and
matter.
It's also different than
his. Don't matter. It's to all of them. That's
man, name who you talking about.
It, she ain't got to. Because
some of them are.
I'm assuming she talking
about. Some of our top rappers are doing stuff. They're out there.
She's
not talking to them.
You
could just take
it. But just because it's not televised, which is like,
you literally take it.
We all got different taste buds when it comes to rap. She just trying to reach all of them. Because all of them, somebody should speak up.
Say a name. Say a name.
Jay-Z's, everybody. Man. I don't know who doing what.
Name some names and then say et cetera. Give me that.
I mean, because I don't think her message is about that, though. It ain't about this.
I think she was talking to somebody specifically. Like, certain. I believe it's about five niggas she could have named on top.
Kendrick,
she was clearly. Kendrick bet on their protesting.
Man, she
what do you need to tweet for?
I was about to bring that up. I'm like, I don't understand why J. Cole.
What the fuck I care about a tweet for?
I don't see why J. Cole would feel a certain way about it, because, like you said about Kendrick, J. Cole is in the trenches.
That's why I say you got to listen to the song. Shit, right? The song says it all. When he answered all this shit in the song to me. He say it in the song.
Man,
it'd be like that. Man, in the song, he tell you, look, I could be doing this, I could be doing that, but since you're doing this and you saying that this is a problem, you got to understand, everybody don't live the same lifestyle and shit. Like when Lil Wayne was talking about how he couldn't speak on how Black Lives Matter and that shit once upon a time and shit. So it was like, okay, because you've been living in a different kind of world and shit than we have.
And he's in tune with that.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
You gotta know yourself.
You're slightly out of touch with most regular black people.
Like, I told you about Dave Chappelle. Like, I felt like famous people in general, they don't live the same life that we live. Like, he even said it. Like, the nigga got pulled over by a nigga who killed another nigga the next day just because he didn't know who he was. So, like, certain people, I mean, that was we're just so biased or in this, we judgmental and everything. Like, I mean, we want them to speak on shit, but then in the back of my mind, we like, man, y'all ain't going through what we going through. No, they're rich. They're not going through what we going
impossible.
Through. So what the fuck do you really want them to say?
Just ride with
they
us.
They pull them over.
I really can't not say anything and just show up when they need it.
And that's what they called it.
Because that's where I see it. Like,
No, you're not doing it.
If you're going to say something,
definitely show up where it's
needed. Say it when it's needed. Like, don't just say something because people say it.
Then say something. You feel me? Yeah, don't do that.
Like, he might not have said nothing yet, man.
Like, all these whack ass.
Right time to say something.
All these whack ass apologies.
When it needs to be said. Like, we don't need him to say shit. Nobody needed him to charge or spearhead no movements. It's already being done. And I'm like, sometimes you just got to wait your turn to speak up. You don't always got to be saying something to be making shit happen and support a movement. You know what I'm saying? Shutting the fuck up is the best
option. How about this? They not listening to niggas. A moment like this, I don't want to sound like Ted Cruz, but we need white people to stand up and start speaking like, this is wrong, y'all.
We're fucking up. Like, I would love to see that NFL commercial with a bunch of white NFL players doing the same shit.
Drew Brees, Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, Jason Witten, just born, just good old boy, white Americans.
What's the running back?
J.J. Watt.
No, the running back. For the Panthers.
McCarthy or McCaffrey.
Christian McCaffrey.
Yeah. Like, yeah. We need a commercial like that. Like, black people, we get it. We gonna stand up. We need to see more white people saying, this has been fucked up. We need to do something. Because we can't do nothing. Like, all we can do is riot, tear some shit up, show them.
And that's another thing, though. It's like, what J. Cole is supposed to say to a bunch of white people?
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's
more or less, people want him to lead us, but it's like, what are you supposed to say to us with all this going on?
To another protest.
That's a lot to put on a man.
Ain't y'all tired of protesting?
You know, it's a lot.
Yeah, and that's another thing. I'm glad you brought that part up. Like, these people crazy as hell trying to put pressure on celebrities. Like, first off, what the fuck are you doing? First.
And the comfort of your own home.
What are you doing?
Tweeting.
So don't, like you tweeting, you Facebooking, you Snapchat.
He's fake, bro.
Oh, man, he not stepping up. He not saying nothing.
He ain't with the cause no more.
What are you saying? What are you doing? Like, you better, some of these people, I know they not doing shit. And they got the nerve to be criticizing and judging the nigga because he
that's
famous.
That's
I only look for J. Cole for music. I don't need J. Cole for his fucking beliefs or none of that shit. If I learn that shit along the way, cool. And then that's how I know, like, oh, I could probably fuck with this nigga if I ever met this nigga. But it's like, at the beginning, he came to me as a fucking rapper. That's all I looked to him for. Fuck, I looked to him for some old black, like, white ass
one,
shit.
One chick was on
I looked at the active Al Sharpton, Jesse, you know what I'm saying? I looked to certain niggas for certain shit. Fuck, I looked like, looked to Trump for ignorance. Like, no, I ain't, come on.
And that's why I was like, he don't even really post shit when he out there. It be the fans that be seeing him. Posted. So
and then it just becomes
for the right reason, because he could be that nigga like, hey y'all, I'm out here, you know what I'm saying, take a picture, like, so it can show that he with us. Like, I mean, I ain't saying all
actors. Like, it's gonna happen, they gotta take pictures.
No, I'm with it.
It's gonna happen.
I'm saying, don't be the one to initiate it, like, show that I'm here, y'all.
Exactly.
Like, nigga, just show up and just be peaceful.
That's why I like with Lil Baby and what you call it, and YG,
they was with George Floyd.
They used footage of their protests
in
their videos.
Stephen Jackson was with Jamie Foxx. I didn't see Jamie Foxx acting all crazy, like, show me, but he was there. You just like, oh shit, there goes Jamie Foxx.
Yeah,
like, niggas was
and
there.
And Trey the Truth was up there.
Just getting out and showing up.
And that's it. Like,
that's it. Because that's what the record
and that original, was. And that original thing, when it first happened, when Stephen Jackson was talking, and all the niggas was wearing black, like, I seen Trey the Truth in that thing. I'm like, what? But that's when I didn't know he was
from
Houston, yeah. So I was just like, dawg. And then Jamie Foxx, like you said, I was like, okay, I'm with that type of shit. I don't need pictures. Let me find out like that.
Don't let it be a publicity stunt. Like, be for the cause and
let it be sincere.
Yeah. So and he's sincere. He shouldn't have to do that.
Do you
like
feel
I said, bro, he spoke his mind and he said everything. He responded to that well to me. Like, he didn't throw no diss. He wasn't disrespectful.
He was like, hey, if you see it,
and he praised her.
Yeah,
like I said, me personally, I feel like he was speaking on behalf of a lot of other rappers. Cause
could have been.
Like he said, okay, I feel like
he definitely said he's staying out.
I know
what
I could,
said, though,
I
like,
could be doing
some
more.
Some people
but,
wanted him to change.
You know, everybody said, like, ain't in a position to even think that way. To be like, to even accept, like, I could do more. Everybody ain't in that space and shit, and it ain't for everybody. You know what I'm saying?
It's not.
So do you think it's a publicity stunt? How they want to recognize Juneteenth, like it ain't like this.
It is whatever.
Like, I think the nigga that runs Twitter, I thing. He recognized it first, like, as a national holiday. Like, he was the first one to, like, jump the gun.
He
like,
don't
oh.
get to nationalize a holiday. He knows about it.
Well, no.
For his employees?
Recognized.
For his employees?
Like, for Twitter. Like, you know, when Twitter come up, it'd be on a day, it'd be, oh, it's July 4th type shit.
To adopt it, then.
Yeah. Recognize it.
It's adopted. Fucking recognize it.
Well, I wouldn't. No, I adopted. Not adopted. Cause
yeah, adopted as a fucking.
That would mean you're trying to, like, come on in. Like, no, it's like, okay, you know what? I've heard of you, but now I'm going to pay you attention. I know, that's what I'm saying. That's what I said. Recognize. It's been here, but niggas haven't recognized it as such. Now they want to recognize it. Like, nigga, you might be able to take the day. You might be able to take the day off work.
It's not recognized.
Well, this was just on what I think was Twitter. But what I think is about to happen is it's about to be a surge of shit like this. For this, and this Juneteenth. Like, everybody is really talking about it now on a more way mass level than it ever has been before.
Not to mention, hey, you got something?
I was just gonna say, I think you gotta probably thank George Floyd for that. Like,
I know Candace would.
Don't want to, but right
now.
You
know who wanted to get thanked for that? You know, the president was saying he needed a little recognition for making Juneteenth so famous.
See?
Because he was supposed to be having a rally today. First rally since
all. This is a great time.
Yes. He didn't know today was Juneteenth. He didn't know what it was about until he learned, and he moved it back to tomorrow on Saturday. So, because today was supposed to be a rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Wait, did he?
Tulsa, see?
That's what I'm saying. He was going to do a rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma on Juneteenth.
That's the cases.
But his campaign, that's like, hold on.
So somebody gave him the background. Look, all his black all right, y'all, y'all be free.
They let him know that wasn't a good look.
Not to mention him and his vice president out there lying, talking about cases are going down.
Next topic.
And cases are going up. And earlier I was like, somewhere I'll go home with. Now we know Tulsa, because it was supposed to be where the rally was. Because that was the whole plot. It was like, hey, y'all, Corona is going down. Don't be worried.
So he went there
come
to
the rally.
He went there to say something about Corona is going away?
Well, no. They were going to have a rally. But at a rally,
election campaign.
Because it's election year. But they like, how are we going to be at a rally with Corona? Like, what you mean? And then you already know, them niggas don't be wearing no mask ever. No. But they like, so because people was worried, they literally just got on some platform and was like, oh man, cases have been, they've taken a precipitous, however the fuck you say the word, drop. And instead, it actually took a fucking climb. Same word, a steep climb. So it was like, so y'all niggas lied just to give me what I'll add a rally, just to try to, you know, do something because you know your time is up. Your time is up.
They say flip of the mouth shit all the time.
Dog.
This nigga Trump.
So like, the nigga was saying it was subsiding, but it was inclining.
Yes. Like, though, whatever Tulsa News came out and said, whatever, we'll get the sources, but I heard it.
Oh, man.
He was like,
we'll get this.
That nigga was like, actually, they're actually taking an incline. I was like, oh,
wait, Fauci check him or was it somebody else?
Man. No, Fauci been out of the way.
Yeah, I know that's what I'm saying. Who checked him?
You don't even get to talk to Fauci and hear about him no more.
We out of there now.
Look, man, it's just fucked up that your president and your vice president, because the vice president is Mike Pence, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, I didn't even know. That's how not in tune I was with this whole presidential thing these last 4 years. But yeah, him and his fucking vice president just was out. The vice president said something first, and he used the smart word precipitously. I may have it. Donald Trump, he can't do all that. He was like, we're taking a steep decline. But they was both wrong. He came out the back of his homie. Like, his homie was out here with some
facts. He just used a bigger word to be wrong with.
Dog, the vice did.
And it's crazy, like.
And then commander-in-chief.
I ain't fucking with that word.
You know, it's crazy. Since all this shit been going on in the past month, as far as George Floyd and all, like, the president and none of his administration have acknowledged, like, the Black Lives. Not necessarily the Black Lives Matter movement, but the whole racial issues going on.
Oh, you like, heard they, say never,
they haven't properly addressed it to the point where it's like actually acknowledging that it's going on. Like, you
like it should never be a press conference.
Hey, looking at them, you would think it ain't shit going on.
Because even when he brought up George Floyd, that was like a couple of seconds before he was talking about the economy, right?
Say that again.
I said, because even when he was talking about George Floyd looking down on us being happy, that was in another conference where he was just talking about the economy, right? Like, he didn't use that time to just talk about George Floyd.
He never specifically just talked about what happened to him, or the, not the incident, but he just brought his name up to just be like, look, there's a lot going on. Like, he never even specifically spoke on the actual situation as it's a lot of reform going on. Like, he was like, yeah, black people, they need the rights and love, but he ain't speak on how it's been messed up. You know what I'm saying? And like, okay, we gonna do something about this. I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna make sure. Like, he ain't gave nobody no comfort or affirmation that he gonna let us. You know, he ain't let niggas think that he was gonna do nothing about it.
And he has.
All right, it's business as usual. Y'all niggas shut up and keep it moving. Like, that's, I ain't gotta say he's a racist. I'm just gonna say he don't know to give a fuck. Because he ain't never had to. Like, he ain't lived in our shoes. He never lived in a hood in America and shit. He been good.
Of course not.
That's like any rich person expecting them to be able to relate to us and shit. I'm like, it's fucked up because we don't got no support from our leader on the movement to change, you know what I'm saying, the civil rights in America, just in general.
Facts.
It's crazy. Because even the Black Lives Matter movement has been getting changed to the Black LGBTQ Lives Matter. Like, they piggybacking off the movement of all black people so they can get rights for gay people. And I'm like, look, y'all had all last year and the year before and shit. Since y'all got the right to be married in a lot of states to do that. It's like, look, y'all always piggybacking. I ain't knocking y'all. Get y'all rights too, because all people deserve rights. But it's like, it just happens every time black people try to, you know, every time it's a
black. Why separate? Next topic. Why separate?
It's not our thing, though.
What? What's not our thing?
LGBTQ is not.
Oh, it's not
a
our
black
thing.
It's a people thing, and it's like every time.
Yeah, I'm saying, like,
they community get something, it's off of the backs of the
next topic.
That go to, I already said it. So it's over. But that go to everybody, like you hear people say, like, all lives matter. Like, clearly, man, clearly we know all lives matter. Nobody is saying kill whitey, only black. We just saying black lives matter because these are lives that have been taken. We don't know the status of all these black people. Some of them could have been gay. Some of them could have been lesbian. Some of them could have been fucking Q. Some of them could have been T. Whatever the fuck the rest of the fucking letters is, I don't fucking know. But you know what I'm saying? Like, so when we say Black Lives Matter, we're not separated. So for the LGABC shit to come out and try to, like, we matter too? No, we're not doing that. All right.
I mean, I'm not gonna even say that it's them. I don't know.
They already got their own movement.
Who are
together?
The powers?
It's black, white,
behind making that happen,
Hispanic, all that. They got the pride.
I don't know who's behind the movement of it. Like, the black LGBTQ lives. Like, just saying it is just like, not just like, but to a degree, saying all lives matter. And I'm like, look, this is not a, like, it's one thing, because I'm like, the LGBTQ community. You know, the alphabet community. Mm-hmm. No offense. Just easier to say.
We just
the alphabet community.
Just can't retain it. That's the wheeze.
They got power. They got pull. In a lot of different sectors. You know what I'm saying? They got pull.
Hollywood locked down.
They can get shit canceled. Black people ain't just getting shit canceled.
They right created cancel culture.
In my mind, y'all could have been doing this shit and not piggybacking off of this. But because it take away from what this is about. Because they quick to make it about y'all and that. And I'm like, look, it's bigger than that. Like, y'all deserve y'all rights, but y'all should do that on your own merit. Because that's a fight for y'all. And they ain't saying that people wouldn't support y'all. It's just, don't try to make that movement ours, too. Because that's not what this is about. And I feel like Black Lives Matter as an organization is trying to do that. That's what I feel the organization is, Black Lives Matter, is trying to do. As opposed to keeping the focus on the whole us as a people, they use this platform to,
like, it's a distraction.
I'm gonna say, and it might be the enemy who's doing that shit. Like, it could be the enemy who's using that.
When we already fighting the same fight, we fighting the same.
Just come out here.
We didn't say Black Lives Matter, not the LGBTQ shit.
They got legislation, and they ain't made no legislation
For us.
For black people as a whole. You know what I'm saying? Like LBGT people, Q people getting legislation, the alphabet people getting legislation for them through our movement. Because that's what happened last time.
Black, is there a
that's,
black history
when they was doing the, when they got the marriage, when they got
I'm
the,
sure
the,
in
the,
somewhere in some state in some Americans.
Well, I mean, it's what it's pride here.
Is it a black festival?
Is it a Black History Month festival? Like it's a pride festival in the month of gay pride.
Who's gonna organize it? Because gay people organize. I would think.
Well, they're very organized. They're very organized.
The gay people.
Yes.
Yes, very much.
Gay,
so.
Gay people are very.
That's what I'm saying. Like, y'all 20, not losing.
They only got 27 days. That's like that shit.
That's like men and women, but it's probably because
they,
women are very organized.
They getting
so
rights pushed through.
If you're a man, if you're gay, you
through legislation quicker than the whole black race is all I'm saying. And I'm like, every time black people got something going on, a movement, they piggyback and they win. And I ain't knocking them for it. It's just like, well, y'all gonna support the real cause?
Don't piggyback.
You got and your at the own same shit. Time, I just
and you successful with the shit. We all know it, and we don't even know what the fuck really for real. We just found out what Q stood for, but we heard about this shit. So y'all doing good. Stay in your own lane. Let us do this shit. We gonna come together. Let's fix one problem at a time. Cause there's some black LGBTQ people who gonna be like, okay, yeah,
I'll just keep fighting both fights. Fight your gay fight and fight your
that's
black
what I'm
fight.
It may be a media thing though. Like the media may turn that into I can't say that they do that.
Like they used to do like famous people marrying each other, like they used to give them nicknames and shit like that. Like man, I can't even think of shit like now, but Brad Pitt and what's that bitch name? Yeah, they used to have like a weird name. Brad Pisha, Lonely. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. But yeah, like they probably just combined it just to get, you know, some old shit going on. But no, fuck all that, bro. Like, I can't believe that they tried to piggyback on that shit. Like, no, not just Black Lives Matter. Guys, what y'all call it again?
You said Black. The Black ABC,
man. The Black Alphabet.
Because I can't, look, LGBT. But then they've added, see what I'm saying?
Q stands for questioning or queer. We just found that out.
I guess. But look, man, I'm just, I can't look.
I don't want to think that we just knew this shit.
Whatever it is, I learned it today. Whatever it is. I think all the black dudes come up with fucking group nine, like Jamaican
Hold on.
African blacks, African American blacks.
So now,
Haitian blacks, and we all fucking.
So now lives is not lives, it's lesbian?
What?
And the B-L-G-L-A-G-L-A.
Oh, so you mean, oh, well.
Is the L still lives?
It might be black lesbians, gays.
Oh, you're talking about Black Lives Matter.
Yeah, the acronym
trans,
now. Like, what the L still
called? Bisexual. Lives Matter.
Okay. Questionable.
So it's B-L-L. L-G. Like, what the fuck is it?
No, it's B.
That's still an L. That's still an L.
No, they just moved it at the back like Rosa.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
They just put the lines at the back of all
this. Black lesbians come first.
It's black, lesbian, gay, trans, questionable,
something, something.
Imitate, whatever. Because I think there's an I in it. I don't fucking know.
There's no longer an
acronym. I look it up.
The L is no longer part of the acronym.
What the fuck?
It's just the last part.
All right. It better be. So now lesbians don't get no love then.
Well, they do. They do.
Where is that? Where they litter at? Queer?
The last part is taken out of the acronym. It's just last part.
Whoa!
Because the new acronym, if you're going to be.
Look at it, now you got to do it.
BGTQL.
It's the L.
That's a whole. It went from BL.
You don't spell a word. It's called blasphemy.
That shit sound like a fucking video game.
Or a math problem that you never solved ever.
Got.
Like, once you solve it, we going to hell.
Welcome to chemistry class. LGBTQ. What the fuck?
Two L's.
To it? I ain't got time.
Because lies and lesbians, baby.
Okay. So, look, what y'all think about how, you know, because I was talking to a friend of mine the other day, and they was telling me, well, they was basically saying how, you know, the culture didn't change to where dudes be wearing skinny jeans and shit. You know, not necessarily just young dudes, but older dudes wearing them down to, like, pants that actually fit. And it's like, where they getting that shit from back in the day? In my day, or, you know, I don't do that shit. That's what I had a person tell me.
I mean, who was this nigga? Because if you think about it, in the 70s, well, they were wearing bell bottoms, and that
I know, it's just
at the bottom.
And they wore shirts with their stomach off, nigga.
They did.
They wore
but that wasn't us doing it.
The niggas had a shirt.
The person I'm talking about wasn't even that old of a person. It was around our age and shit, in their 30s and shit.
So baggy pants is what they used to?
Not necessarily baggy, but it was just, you know.
It was a loose fit.
You know how we used to dress as opposed to, we you know, people dress.
The Jabos, the elite chains.
The guest outfits.
I want to admit, I switched it up a bit too as I got older. You know, I wear clothes that fit now as opposed to saggy. Big ass tall
I seen a movie with a teenager with some baggy pants on. It was supposed to be relevant to today, and I'm like, I don't even think kids wear baggy pants no more. Like,
No, they wear the tight shit.
They just sag.
And my friend was like, I seen some kids with some baggy pants. Like, who, white trash? Cause I don't see like teenagers with fucking baggy pants no more. I don't
who
see
white trash.
Dog, that's all I could think
so
of.
They still living the. Living
like,
the life.
Yeah, like, we'll hold it down for you, bro. Like, hey, bro. Like, I just don't see young kids wearing baggy jeans no more. And I get it. Like, it was never really supposed to be. Like,
it might happen later, but it's not about to happen this soon.
And I'm cool with people wearing pants that fit you.
You know what I think it comes down to, like I said, it's a cultural thing. The culture changing. Like, this high fashion shit. Got the culture switching up, like
next topic. You trying to get it?
You know, I already been
there. I know, but I just I know, and I'm pissed off.
He segue. He segue.
I was like,
and he segue.
No, I'm so thinking, I'm like, am I that for real? But I didn't want to say shit. Like, but yeah,
anyway, they digress.
We definitely do.
But yeah, you know, just the whole concept of being high fashion, all these expensive ass jeans that fit your whole nutsack. To a T, and it's like, what the fuck? You know, I ain't knocking it either. It's just, I ain't supporting all that shit. Like, I'm not wearing no shit that look like I got on jeggings.
Yeah, no, and like you said, I feel
no jeggings.
I'm not doing it.
I feel like it's about it's famous people just getting away with whatever they want to wear. They rich now, they can wear whatever they want to wear. Like I said,
what make you think they want to wear that shit though? Like, what is the switch up? Like, do they
the
just
switch
not
up is,
do they not make the type of like? Is it because them bitches expensive and you can tell them this what I'm wearing? Don't you wear like that shit? Or it's because I always wanted to wear shit like this?
Like, okay, I gotta say this real quick.
Or am I getting paid to wear shit like this? They telling me to wear shit like this.
This is my disclaimer. I love T Grizzly. I love the movement he got. I love the month. I love the music he making. But the clothes he wearing.
Oh, shout out to Detroit artists.
There you go. But the clothes.
Shout out to Grizzly.
The clothes he wearing right now, I just really don't feel like he was wearing that when he was, you know, talking about, you know, being a can you say a word for me?
Jewelry.
Thief.
Jewelry thief.
Yeah, like back in the day when he was talking about that shit. Like,
well,
I don't see
not when
Taz pin.
Well, when you're stealing, you can't wear it.
It depends. If he was stealing that shit and going to buy them shits with it.
Well, no.
That's my thing. Look, are they wearing this shit because it's high fashion
is
how you like to dress?
I'm about to say, is your style changing? Because just because, you know, you go from no-name brand to name brand, I'm with that. Is your style changing?
You know
when you said it was Young Thug walking around the block
with cheap dresses
with like a dress on, nigga.
No, like, now he can got the new one. He can buy the most.
There is no explanation. Now look, I got a defense for the niggas with the skinny jeans. The people who make the jeans that they wear, they don't make them to fit no other way. Like, you can't just buy.
Oh no, that's the way it's made.
Exactly, they weren't making them bitches.
Which I didn't even know back that day until I tried to purchase something.
They clearly wasn't making
them. It ain't that you buying skin, like you just buying some thin. Those are specifically like the hug your leg and the look like that. I'm like, oh word,
and that shit, that's
amazing.
It's affecting the culture. Like, I ain't saying, look, I'm not arguing that it's good or bad. I'm just saying it's clearly affecting the way that people dress.
Bell bottoms fit. They wasn't saying.
But it was different. They didn't have no rips and holes.
They tried to hold them in.
Well, of course not. That's how you change the game.
It was like stretch pants.
That's how you change the game.
Yeah.
But
that is, I just feel like some of our favorite rappers or just people that's famous in totality. I don't feel like
people that get
they would
some
wear
money.
That same shit if they was just broke. Like, I just don't feel like that would be your style.
Me personally, I think they get paid to wear that shit.
They put some agenda.
Would you know about Mike Amiri? You ever heard of Mike Amiri? Do you think you'd have knew what True Religion was had motherfuckers not told you about it? Because I didn't
know. Not at all. You're right.
Shit, Balenciaga.
Bathing Apes.
Bathing Apes.
All that shit. You're right. All that shit that they put in our rap songs
and then we listen to it, and then we, the informed nigga want to go find out what that is, and now he cashing out.
I could definitely see a nigga like, hey man, I'll pay you this much money, shout me on your next song.
Easy.
Oh, that's what they do with that Fashionista.
I'm going to send you about $10,000 worth of shit.
Dog, I didn't know Fashionista was
all I'm looking for is a shout out in the song.
That's all you need.
And then they wear it in the video.
I know for a fact Jay-Z had that shit happen because, you know.
It's like silent endorsements.
It is. It's endorsement.
It's a silent endorsement. Sure.
Like, they just don't know.
And it only makes sense.
Like, it's a subliminal message that is going to get through, and niggas not going to see, and this is going to be like, wow, like, now we buying that shit. Like, because our favorites are wearing that shit. You know, like, got to say,
man. I didn't know what Cristal was until the rappers
told. Like, it's. Rap will put you on so much shit that you can't afford, and then you go out and try to get
it. That's how powerful it is.
Exactly.
Look, and that's the thing.
It's supposed to motivate. Like, that's been the whole thing, because we know everybody rapping came from where we came from, for the most part.
That's what No Name was talking about. Like, that's the spirit of where she was coming from. Like, you know how influential our culture is, and rap culture is. And how influential some of these people is. Like, y'all need to come up with something good to say to people to lead them in a proper direction.
It's just fucked up that people do feel like that.
Follow these
things. Like I said, I look to them for rap. Fuck, I don't give a
fuck. I was watching this one documentary.
Regardless of what you saying that, but bro, you are already, like, bro, you've been indoctrinated through that shit yourself. And not just through the rap, but through the culture of black culture. This is what they pushed us to perceive black culture as. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't never seen a movie about a white pimp. For real. Like, you might, maybe they was, but they was in black movies, or it was a comedy, but you ain't never heard no real history of white pimps. Right, like, it wasn't never white pimps. I guarantee it was. You know what I'm saying? They was doing it too. But it was promoted in our culture and shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just like the drug dealer. The biggest drug dealers in the world are Caucasian people and other people. It ain't black people and shit, dog. Like, Big Meech made hundreds of millions. His niggas made billions. Like, his plug wasn't black. Like, it wasn't, you know what I'm saying? Like,
it's plugged,
they doing the same shit we do. They just getting all the money for real. Yeah, like shit, you know what I'm saying? But we pay the consequences of living the lifestyle.
I was watching this fashion clothing documentary that was talking about how these famous white people don't want us to be the leaders of their fashion because we push waves. And when we get done with a wave, their business dies. Mark Buchanan, Cross Colors. True Religion. Like, once we get tired of a wave, it's like we'll cash out and you'll get a whole lot of money. But once we done with it, we like, that shit whack now. Tommy Hilfiger, another one. Like,
all kind of shit.
Like, once we take over, it's cool. Once we like your shit, we will get it's everybody
fad.
With it.
But dressing is all fad. It's about what's being promoted.
To ran through all of them. Black people ran through all that shit.
Oh, they are?
I mean, they still making shit and stuff.
But I'm saying that's why they don't want black people to be their main consumers. Like, because they know that once we get tired of something, white people will follow us and like, I don't want to fuck with it. But if you got white people already just with your shit, like, that's why you think all that racist wear come out? Like, with the monthly outfit and
fat shit.
Nigga, all top. That Gucci shit that they're trying to cancel.
Our culture is a consumer culture. We're culturalized to consume from motherfuckers. So,
and people,
the motherfuckers telling us to go get this shit, that's the reason we going to get it, because motherfuckers, we aspire to be like, going to get it, got it.
Like, well, me and you was talking about that the other week, Young Dro. Nigga, he wanted to be different. He wanted to be that other nigga who wasn't dressed like everybody. Start wearing polo. Niggas like us is like, well, that's different. You know what I'm saying? We went up on polo. Well, you, okay, you want to be that guy now? All right, well, I wasn't fucking with polo. But when I seen your drug fucking with polo, I wanted to be unique, too.
How did you fucking with polo at that age? You had to wear
a uniform. Nigga, what kind of shirts was I wearing? Polo shirt.
You had to wear
Ralph Lauren shirts. You know the polo shirt.
You know where
it comes from.
Yes.
It's not polo Ralph Lauren.
But he told me, but Joe is
shirt. Did Joe come? All right, no, we was. All right, so I guess so when you graduated, you started wearing polo.
So now, first of all,
so you was rocking me, and you was like, yeah, bro, I'm with
you. I wasn't wearing no polos. No, I was trying to remember the time.
Who was you aspiring to be when you was a young man? Because I was aspiring to be Dope Man. And that nigga was wearing Prada, Gucci. He was wearing all that shit that I wanted to wear.
I got
to
pee, y'all.
You know, he was aspiring. Like, I was aspiring to be like that.
I was on some hoop shit.
Yeah, I mean.
Don't let it die out. I like the hoop. Keep it going.
Son, be quiet.
We should start a pause. We're gonna pause, y'all. This is a commercial break. Don't forget to like and subscribe, y'all. Hit that like button, hit that notification bell button, so every time we release new content, you know first. Come right to your phone, baby, and you can watch us. Yes, yes.
Because we know you own that bitch.
Don't forget to check us out on Anchor on the...
This ain't that podcast.
You know, I be fucking it up, dog.
He always fucking it. He gonna get fired.
Fuck you. It's not my
that job. Ain't this.
That's that
job. Ain't this.
You know what I said?
No. That ain't what you said.
Man, look, I'm sorry. I get confused sometimes.
Because you think these niggas don't listen to Jeezy.
I know, sir. I get confused. Shut up. Because you stupid, man. I like Jeezy though. Hold on. What the fuck? Yo, shit. He the only weirdo that don't like Jeezy, but it's not from here. Hey, he from Florida. Hey, yeah, he like Rick Ross. I like Rick Ross too. I don't like Rick Ross. I know you. Oh, you don't like Rick Ross. Nobody from, like, Ray Shrimmer. He like Rick Ross. Atlanta, I think. Who knows? No offense. I fuck Ray Shrimmer. They from like Minnesota.
Okay, we gonna get it. You already know. Backwoods? Oh, leaf. Yeah. Why you? So leaf, you got backwoods? Why? What? Why the fuck you playing harvest? I didn't get it. I just asked my, yes. You a playing gatherer? I don't like that shit. So when you ask somebody who's experienced on that. Son, it was a bad one, and I made it fucking work, bitch. I mean, I already know how to roll this shit.
Anyway, so where we at with it? Got one for y'all. People. Because we all are people.
Next topic.
Like he said, next topic.
Anyway, I think it just be neat and
You know, it was a discussion amongst the people.
Hey, yo.
You know, because the people discuss shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we want to talk. So, a friend of mine brought a question to me and shit because he was having some problems. And I'm sure y'all might, I'm not sure, but I, y'all may be able to relate or know people who are going through this similar shit. But a friend of mine was asking me, all right, bro, you be doing that podcast. You talk, like, ask the people, you know, because they want to, you know. It's one thing for us to talk about it, but for us to talk about it and the people to talk about it, yeah. Y'all motherfuckers, y'all talk about it too. Comment.
Oh, like, yeah. Comment below. I always tell motherfuckers to comment.
Talk shit about our shit.
Why the fuck?
So we can talk you shit say about something? Stupid hey. Motherfucking cup. Glass, I should make you dumb son.
He ass in his cup.
You're stupid.
That's what he's doing.
I'm drinking ass.
Here, here. You don't even use it.
He don't know how to fucking smoke
and drink ass.
Why you fucking up? I don't know, because you're stupid. You're
that's why his name is I don't know. He don't never know what the fuck he's doing.
Why you fucking up? I don't know.
Dumb ass bitch is over there just ashing in your cup.
Next topic.
Why you grown as hell and you don't know how to smoke and drink?
Because I don't be drinking and smoking.
They got songs about this. You can't listen to the song.
I don't like
that. I smoke. I drink. Not you.
I hope to stop, but I can't.
Son, you need to stop.
Anyway.
Okay.
Lord.
Like I said, my peoples was trying to ask me. They told me to bring the question to the peoples. When you're in a relationship where you dealing with somebody or you've been fucking with somebody over a period of time, anybody, significant other or whatever you want to call them, whatever.
Some type of relationship.
Anybody you fucking with.
Don't argue
even
semantics.
If it's your mama, daddy, it don't matter. But we more particular talking about your relationship, a personal relationship.
Man,
but
be all right. Over
how do you tell the person you fucking with that they getting a little big or they need to slow down on the eating or they need to adjust their weight? Like, how do you
third.
Do, what y'all think the best way to go about doing it?
I call third. I go last.
We're going to start with, I don't know.
What you got for us?
Well, this is a funny topic because I was just watching this little exercise bike commercial on YouTube that got a lot of flack because in the commercial, the man, I think it's called a Peloton bike or something like that.
Peloton. I'm hip. I seen that.
Yeah. So
a treadmill for the people
real good.
For the people who not familiar.
Say so you're real good.
I knew that. He's wrong.
Say so smarter than
that. He like, yeah, so you're right. But yeah.
I'm in my mode.
I see dog. So the commercial, the husband buys an exercise bike for his woman. She didn't ask for it. He just bought it. She likes it. She works out on that. I mean, that's what the premise is of the commercial.
For sure, for sure.
Yeah.
They didn't tell us in the commercial. She but, like, ooh, thanks, daddy.
Like, it wasn't one of those, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, so in the commercial, she works real hard. She shows footage of her working out, and she shows the man and this and that. And a lot of women were offended by that because it was like, you know, that's fatism or some shit you can say. I don't give a fuck what it is. But it was just funny because it was attacking the whole commercial saying, like, why do we need a man to show us that we need to lose weight and this and that. And so I also have a friend.
Question? Answer?
Who the fuck don't show you? Like,
God damn it, bitch. Don't you shut up. That was my answer.
Yeah, I'm with it.
You wasn't last. Yeah, shut up.
I haven't even been able to go first all the way.
Yet. I know, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I thought you was asking us.
No, I
didn't. How? Shut up. I don't know.
Fucking, I just said.
That was rhetorical or something. I don't know what the fuck
I
you
said.
Heard.
Question, answer.
Can't be rhetorical in the podcast. Right, what right, the right, fuck? Right, so, right, anyway, let me keep going, though. So, I looked at the commercial. I laughed. Man. I was with a friend when I watched that. She was like, what happened?
He just mad that I said what he was gonna say.
Took my answer.
Yeah, that's joking.
You did not. I'm sorry. That shit came out of me.
All right, no, I'm sorry. He had to think of something else when I keep talking.
Come on, man.
All right. You stop. Bitch, who the stop.
You don't stop.
No, he won't stop. He won't stop. You know.
Bitch, who the fuck don't. Okay.
Thank you. Oh, okay. He's doing better. So, yeah. But so, I also had a friend.
Bitch, what? I digress.
Also have a friend who likes big women, but. He told me one time, I hope you don't watch this because he might get a little mad, but he was telling me that his girlfriend who was big, because he loved big women.
His girl, see, she going to get mad.
I hope she don't watch. I hope they don't watch this together.
Hey, man, shout out his friends.
Don't you know best this together. Thing?
Right. Is it you? Am I the big bitch? No.
Who he talking about? Who he talking about?
Stop. Come on, we got to stop being funny. We got to just keep this shit real. So, long story short, I'm going to speed it up real fast. He loves fat girls. His girl was getting bigger. And he called me to let me know that his girl was getting bigger. I tried to change the subject because I thought we were done with it. I just thought that's what big people do. He like, no, man, I really want to talk about this. And I'm like, well, what did you...
He thought big people just keep getting bigger.
Like, I didn't know that was a... Like, he said...
Say big people like...
He said... Insert name here like, is getting bigger.
Water balloons.
So you think
keep putting it in
so you think big people is like Pringles.
Once you stop.
Once you pop,
I mean, you can't,
it don't stop.
Yeah. But I didn't know that you gonna tell like you don't say such and such is big. Like I know that, I have eyes. And then he like, no, wait, brother. She getting bigger.
She bigger,
like
oh,
what the fuck?
Is she? Is
so,
he?
Like, but you like your big girls, and I've seen them date a girl bigger than that. It was like he was like, look, man.
It's all in the beginning process, yeah, apparently.
He said, I like big girls.
I'm like, that's
but you can't get bigger. And I'm like, at first I was mad because it sounded stupid, but then I thought about it, like, it makes sense. Like,
you're not the person I fell in like with. You're not the person I fell in
like
with.
Yeah, like, I accepted this. Nothing more. I guess nothing less. Like,
cause some niggas,
I would figure he would have a limit. Like, you can only be so big.
That's what I thought, but it's like, I mean...
Or, when you meet, if I meet you like this, and your bigness matches the sexiness that I think you got, okay, cool.
Well, this is my thing.
But don't get bigger.
You like smaller ones? Like smaller big women? Because big is different to
kind of... It sounds like whatever you like. It sounds like whatever you like. Because I'm the same. Look, 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 look.
You're obese.
I know, everybody's obese.
By definition.
Yeah. I'm not obese.
You're not.
But... Well, no, okay. Well, I'm saying most doctors.
I'm not quite there.
Well, you see some obese.
But you're close.
See my arm? Ain't no obese here.
Stop.
I'm talking to the people.
Don't talk to them. They don't look. Hey.
But anyway.
But, no, so when I'm.
If he do this, the whole table is shaking.
It ain't a jiggle.
And I'm going to get money. But, That's right. Look, man.
Women be stripping.
So, yeah. So, I thought about it, and I've seen people who I'm close with who got bigger, and I just don't know. Like, is that something that you can even bring up to your significant other? Well, shout out to somebody that's signed to, he couldn't say it. Got you, baby.
Oh, shit.
No, it, not his girl. It, just the word significant other he couldn't say. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah. He said a name.
You say his name.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
He's married to Anonymous.
Right. Well, yeah, so, is it a way to say it? Oh, you know I'm about to hit the drugs over here. There you go.
I think it is. If you're sincere about it.
You are sincere. She's fat as fuck. I'm tired of that.
Not because you're just mad and tired. It's because you're properly concerned. Like, I want you to do better because I know you can. You should want to do better. Because it ain't just... Because how a nigga who fucking with big girls...
Right.
And have fucked with bigger girls...
Yeah.
Gonna tell a big girl, baby, you can't get no bigger. That's like, if you go cheat... Because in my mind...
was when I met you.
I'm hip. If you go cheat, he's gonna cheat with a smaller bitch or a bigger one.
He gonna cheat
with... Or she got to be what she was.
She's gonna be same size.
I mean, it's going, like you said, though, in a way, though, it's going to be with somebody he just met this moment. I see you right now. I'm cool with you being this weight. Now, he knows.
This is what I fell in like with. This image. Don't change this. Because some niggas don't want you to get smaller.
Mm-hmm.
If a nigga don't want you to get smaller, then clearly it's the other side of the coin. Because a nigga may not want you to get bigger.
If she's gotten bigger, he wants her to get smaller.
Okay, well.
Now, is it a cap on that?
Well, how about this?
We're probably back to the original liking of the beginning.
We can't use him. He's an anomaly. I want to know what you motherfuckers think.
Well, no, that's him.
Okay, so I want to know what you think. Like, is it, could you, huh?
How would I talk to my girl?
Yeah, like, is that something you would bring up? Like, would you tell your girl?
Yeah.
And how would you cut into her?
It just depends on the situation.
On that, I'm going to do it with you because I'm the one who has to complain. Even though I might be sweet. What you think, though?
Oh, she gotta be sweet.
I'm like that nigga that's...
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Even if I am sweet to her, I would still do that with her because she gonna need somebody to help her. Like, it's always good to do something with a
team. Gross, that's your woman.
Yeah. What about you, DJ, please?
I'm like the nigga waiting on the wrestling ring in the tag match waiting to get in.
That's why you did
it's
that?
It's my turn. Oh, I was...
That was the shaking on the rope type thing?
Let me in. Bitch, tighten up. That's what I say. Those are my little...
You never did that.
I literally be like, hey.
Well, okay. I know situations like, okay. You don't need friends, nigga.
Oh, my God. Y'all know I'm ignorant as hell.
Listen, not with that.
Nigga, I straight up, I be like, hey, you know that stomach over there, you need to tighten that up. What you doing?
You want two of them bitches?
Like, you know what I'm saying? And everybody I ever been with and the women I've talked to in my life, like not talked to like trying to get at, but like spoken with, I tell them all the time. I say, no, if a girl, if I get with you and you get fat, it's over. They be like, oh, you supposed to love them any old kind of way. Yes, you're right. I love you any old kind of way. I'm not going
to
be with
you.
It's
supposed to be to death do you part, not fat.
That's when you get married.
Oh, shit.
All right, so that's what that's
I ain't
that.
I don't let my wife get fat either.
Off top, so it's like no, you start getting big.
When you don't believe in couple weight, like when you just like continue.
Yeah, when you get old, but I ain't there.
I'm about to say, nigga, yeah.
And even then, you can keep it together then.
You seen that P90X ass nigga? He was like 50.
Nigga, Shannon Sharp looked way better than all the realists combined.
He 50.
That nigga
old. So, nigga, ain't nobody trying to hear that. Nah, bitch, nigga, tighten up.
No, you got those Southern jeans. I had to wash my ass outside.
Skip. I got good jeans.
Hey, skip. I washed my ass outside. Skip.
Don't.
Skip, you hear me? Yes!
Don't
Shannon Sharp, man. Shout out to my nigga Shannon Sharp, dog.
Love that nigga,
and he'll be cool with us saying nigga. It's blunts and really black in my house and the hand on.
So he already know. I don't fuck with LeBron James, but outside of that, you know I don't.
I feel like I should fight for the niggas who love LeBron, but I don't
fuck with LeBron as a person. I don't care for, man, look, I don't
as a person, yeah, he clearly dope as fuck. He has done some sweet ass shit, so let me say that. My dislike and hate for LeBron is strictly basketball.
Sports!
That's right, he trash.
He's been incredible in basketball.
That's incredible. He's been one of the greatest, but this is
amazing.
Steph Curry.
Had he not been this, nigga.
R.I.P. Cole.
All right, Skip.
But,
fuck with that one.
Skip, what he said, Skip.
Yeah, because he'll beat your ass.
I did.
Shannon Sharp will beat your ass saying shit about LeBron.
I'm Shannon, my friend. I did hear him.
I'm shooting. Okay.
I did hear him.
He's too big.
He's very big.
Too big. And he used to be a tight end. He's a Hall of Fame tight end.
Yeah,
I don't have nothing. No. Santa Sark come at me, man, I'll apologize.
Got a handgun either. You need a shotgun.
I'll apologize as I shoot. I'm sorry. And I shoot him in like his leg. Because I don't want no status.
I just try to defuse the situation. I don't want nothing bad to happen.
You're going to be better than a police officer.
Yeah, because we both black, so it's different. I don't want to shoot black people for no reason.
I said, if he running at me to fuck me up.
Oh, I'm going to shoot him. I don't care if you purple, bitch.
But yeah, you were saying, you off the subject, go ahead. You were saying that you tell.
Yeah.
I let him know.
Yeah, like.
I didn't get with you. Don't get with me and start letting yourself go. That's laziness. I don't like laziness. If other people like laziness, cool. That's what you like. Teach his own. I don't like laziness. You get
bro,
with me?
Bro,
I got with you this
working
way.
Working out takes a certain you level can, of discipline and self-control, bro.
You can get
and
thicker.
Ambition. Everybody
you can get thicker. Because, you know, most of my women, because, you know, go back to episode three.
My women.
You go back to episode three. Most of the women that I have been with in my bad. All of them.
I'm just gonna edit and say most of my women.
Little.
Typically, what I like.
I'm smoking weed, bitch. Yeah, you know what the fuck I'm trying to say?
No.
All of the women I've ever been with in my life. Okay, it's a shape.
All my bitches. All of them.
I don't have none now, but in my life, all my bitches, ain't none of them ever been fat. So when you I got, know, if I get with you like this, don't get fat.
Shout out to the big girl
three.
Cause I
shout out to the big girl.
I love y'all.
It's somebody out there for y'all.
I got somebody,
and he'll keep telling you it's not him.
Two of these, it's not me. It's not me.
Mike's fucking with y'all though.
Oh, I love beautiful.
And he's single ready to mangle.
I like him when I mean, you know, if you cute, you cute. But no.
All right. Let's go something else.
Episode three, just running back. We talked about
W versus BWW, whatever the fuck you said.
Say WWE versus BWW.
I said BMW, but it's BBW against BMW.
Yeah. All right, so final thoughts on thoughts on the subject, y'all.
If it's bothering you, you gotta let them know. But you gotta be able to
You can't be quiet. You can't be quiet about it. Because they just gonna keep getting bigger.
Those mouths gonna get fed, and some of that bitch who won't stop eating. So, yeah, I mean, if you don't want to cheat. Which we all don't, we don't condone that, we don't promote that. So yeah, you right. It has to be something said. You gotta find a way. Just be kind with it and just be,
and be ready for that. It ain't just about weight, because it's a lot of shit that people need to work on, like in relationships.
Because
it might not be about weight. It might be about a bad habit, like smoking, drinking, or anything.
She hanging might out on you. I think you're getting big. Why do you drink too much?
You think you think you gonna tell her she getting big and she ain't gonna tell you you be fucking up?
One of your flaws.
Come on, man. It's unexpected. And y'all got the, you know, you got the compromise.
I fucks with that. So just be ready to help your woman. Because like you said, that journey of exercising is a hard one. You need all the support you can get. And just know that her being a female or anybody, if you attack them, they're going to have something against you. So just be able to work on your flaws that you may have.
But that's what you're supposed to be doing. Like, it's a shame that you got to figure out how to tell somebody to do something that you want them to work on. And it's mostly because it comes from criticism as opposed to be like, look, let's work together. Let's work on this and shit.
Word. Let's be the best.
I want this too.
Let's be the best for each other and be the best.
Yeah, let's be partners. Bitch, we in this shit. Yeah. Let's do it.
Let's be in shape together. But no, if y'all go see
not
the commercial.
Shit, like he said, any flaw.
Whatever it is. Like, let's do it.
If your girl gets stupid, about to get fat and she don't like you drinking, you
if
stop
you
drinking.
The nigga about to get fat.
Oh,
if
about
you drink too much and you fucked up looking
stupid. All relationships have to be a compromise. Please understand that, people. You're not going to get in no relationship with somebody and try to be no dictator and don't get no relationship with somebody and conform. It should be a compromise. It's a two-way street.
Unless you're going to do it. Shout outs to my nigga Nelly, who only had a couple of hits. But I'm talking about against Luda. Luda won.
Okay,
Luda
won. Say that then.
I didn't want to.
Nelly,
that was clickbait.
Let's go.
I just let y'all know.
So you want to be clickbait like
say something to make you like huh?
Like
oh,
young,
yeah, I agree.
Like young Nene Leakes, huh? That's what you want to do.
Next topic.
She was like, bait.
So, real quick, We are clearly living in an era where people have all type of platforms, and they just able to, you know, they able to say whatever they want. Clearly, right? Clearly, some people probably don't need to say nothing. They probably should shut the fuck up. So one of these people that probably should shut the fuck up, clearly, Donald Trump. Clearly. And he our president, so he's supposed to talk.
Which is fucked up. Pause y'all for a second. Y'all, we gonna start a segment of our show of just shut the fuck up. Because sometimes people just need to shut the fuck up, like my brother here just said. So from time to time, we're going to address people who just need to shut the fuck up.
Candace Owens.
You'd be better off not talking.
I was laughing.
But Candace Owens. Until you start talking. Mm-hmm. You start with an A in the class, and then you throw that shit out the window and end up with a goddamn failing grade.
So, you know, we're going to start it off with this. NeNe Leakes. She from Real Housewives of Atlanta. First time I found out about this business or about her was years ago, because I had a girlfriend that watched that shit. So, you know, I just seen her. It was like,
wasn't her first shit like Apprentice or some shit like that?
I have no clue.
She was on a different TV show. She didn't start off with Real Housewives.
That's where I saw her first.
I think she was on that Donald Trump shit.
I don't know.
That you're fired. Shit.
She may have been, but I'm not 100%.
Well, more reality TV.
Only black woman I remember.
So all right. So she was. She's still a reality TV star.
But she may have. I'm not.
She was doing other stuff.
We'll look it up.
But yeah. But like, I don't know what else she was doing. But you know, she was on Real Housewives.
Yeah, but
years
ago. Was saying,
so I didn't know she was still on here.
Get to the reason why she needs to shut the fuck up.
So no. So she's still on the show, like, cause I didn't know.
No, son. I said get to the reason why.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. She on the show, and she having a talk with whoever, some type of interview or whatever, radio shit, whatever. And she's saying she felt like she was getting ganged up on, like George Floyd was getting ganged up on, and then stated.
talking about the now deceased
George Floyd. Rest in peace, George Floyd.
I ain't hearing nothing about this.
You know, sorry and condolences to his family and friends and all that. No, we ain't laughing at that. We laughing at her. So then she goes on to say he was ganged up on physically.
Stop. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Is footage of her saying this?
Yes.
Like audio.
It's audio.
I can hear her saying. Yes. I feel like George Floyd.
I'm watching this shit so hard.
She said, I feel ganged up on like how George Floyd is ganged up on. She said he was physically ganged up on. And I was verbally ganged up on. And she talking about her castmates.
She was defining being ganged up on.
Like, yep,
she
with wasn't George originally Floyd, just talking by her castmates.
She brought
her
this
job.
Shit up. Like, bitch, you could have left that out. Like, we know what getting ganged up on. You didn't have to define being
her job.
So she was trying to describe
and use this as an analogy. And
that's why I said it was clickbait. She was looking for a sound bite. Like, you just wanted to state some shit that's going on in the
hashtag
world.
Hashtag George Floyd.
Like and on, you used it the wrong way. Completely.
Because
it's
that one be.
My bad. But that's what made me want to say. It's like, this is your job. You can leave. You don't have to work here. You can quit the show.
You could have been that Asian that was right there. He could have just walked the fuck away. You could just walk the fuck away.
Dave Chappelle walked away from his own show.
Oh, my God.
You couldn't walk away from
that
the show.
That was named after him.
Like, I don't care who owns it. It was the Chappelle show.
Getting ganged up.
Like, you could have hung up the phone, baby.
You guys about to murder me.
You could have hung up the phone.
You could have murdered me with words.
She's going to go shoot another show with these bitches. Whenever they shoot it, like, come on, man.
Yeah,
so
I'm not with none of that.
I'm like, y'all get into it every show, Nene. So
this is why we got to shut the fuck up. Yeah, I'm with that.
That's what I'm saying.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, like I wish we'd have had this out when Donald Trump said, and I just know George Floyd is
looking down on us. Looking down on us, saying it's a great day.
Wait,
he could be a part of because he's murdered.
Where's the coach name?
Tekashi
6ix9ine.
Shut the fuck up.
He's crying about the. Man, he need to be canceled the fuck up.
y'all said we were going to
what the coach nigga name?
No, we named him.
Kara. Shut the fuck up. You didn't need to speak. You should have shut the fuck up.
I wanted to hire him too. I regret not hiring him.
Yeah.
You can still do it.
He's still here.
Kendrick Perkins, shut the fuck up, nigga.
I don't know why people think they care about what Kendrick Perkins got to say.
Nigga. Like, if you ain't with
stop it, letting him on ESPN.
God,
he got the ugly mean face. That's why they like him, because he smiles.
If you talk about all lives like
George
matter,
Foreman. George shut had that the mean fuck ugly face.
Up. Off top.
If you talking about any other lives matter, because we all know all lives matter.
Clearly, it's first obvious. And foremost. It's obvious. Black it goes lives unsaid. Matter,
we trying to accomplish. Look, can I paint a picture for y'all real quick?
Paint that
people.
Shit, my nigga.
Could you imagine if you was walking down the street with your homie or somebody you love, your best friend, your lover, anybody you care about, walking up the street with them, right?
Right.
They get attacked by a mob of motherfuckers instantly, or anything bad happens to them, they can catch a stray bullet, hit them. They laying on the fucking ground bleeding. You like, somebody help me. Somebody help us. Help them. She dying. He dying. My friend dying.
Right.
We need help.
Right.
And motherfuckers walk by and be like, well, what's going on? They dying, but it's, you know, people die. And you scream out, look, help us. My friend need help. I need help helping my friend. My friend life matter. And the motherfucker tell you, look, shit, that's true, but everybody's life matter. And, you know, all lives matter. Like, shit. Your friend life matter. That's what it's like when you saying black lives matter and people telling you all lives matter.
Because
it's like, it ain't that all lives don't matter. It's like, nigga, I'm in trouble right now. Bitch, we dying out here.
Oh,
we need help. Somebody come fuck with us. Yeah, shit. It's like, we know all lives matter. We know if you stop right now, it's going to take a little bit from you and yours, but shit, you might be able to save minds. And I'm like, is that not important?
That's definitely true. That's
so
true.
That's why Black Lives Matter, and that's why we saying it.
Yeah, I'm with that.
All lives matters, but all lives can't matter until Black Lives Matter. And that's what we out here for, baby. Let's roll.
If you're not with us, you're against us right now.
You're against life.
It's very simple.
Us.
Of this all is the final statements, because this podcast was over.
Final statement. Florida governor blames coronavirus rise on overwhelmingly Hispanic workers.
I thought you were going to say overweight Hispanic workers. Which doesn't matter. But
the reason there's coronavirus, the reason the coronavirus is taking an uptick is because of the
Didn't that bitch, I'm from the same city, so I don't want to do this, but didn't that bitch from Jacksonville say that shit? Like, we don't drink Coronas out here. Like, she was mad as hell, saying that dumb shit.
Say we drink,
something bud from a glass.
But I don't know, it was something she was like.
But now they bringing it back on the Mexicans again?
We don't catch it, we not catching Corona because we don't drink Corona beer out here. That's what she was saying.
Like, that's the Mexican.
She from Florida. She from Florida.
You didn't see that?
So I don't even want to see it.
The podcast about to be over.
Let me ask y'all this. How y'all feel about Hey Bay Bay? Remember that?
Hey Bay Bay? Yeah, I remember him.
Yeah, he got arrested for murder in Louisiana.
What's that nigga name?
Hurricane Chris. Apparently he's arrested for murder.
Been in Louisiana.
Yeah, he claimed that hood shit for a while.
Been in it.
He was beefing with niggas too. Like, y'all don't know how
lit
is like.
Still a hood nigga. Like,
he definitely.
Last time I seen Hurricane Chris, he was in the hood with a nigga.
Nigga.
I'm like, are you still doing? Yeah, be like that. If he wasn't Hurricane Chris, we wouldn't know about it.
Turn it off, pal.
Turn it off.
And I don't want to. Like I said, he always talking about shit. We on the podcast.
You know what I'm saying?
That ain't this.
We appreciate y'all. That ain't this. Yes, bitch. Don't say it like you're questioning it.
I'll be fucking.
He's still trying to question. Is it? I don't know.
Yeah, I know. I really wanted to be.
I don't know.
That's really what I wanted.
And he gonna make me mad because I'm gonna start thinking it's that.
I know. That's why I'm so fucked up, y'all. Y'all listen. Look, this ain't that.
Oh, it's in my brain.
We appreciate y'all.
Y'all enjoy y'all Juneteenth weekend. Everybody
happy Juneteenth.
Love, peace, happiness, all that great shit.
Somebody
you know what I'm
head.
Saying? Stay out the way. Respect yourself and respect
somebody
others.
Somebody took my dick.
Live life and live long. Live happy, live peace.
Females.
Bam. We out here.
He had to say females, didn't he?
Yeah, I did.
Because you nasty.
I'm not that nasty.
So you nasty as hell, man.
Turn it off, man.
She said, bitch, turn it off.
Put the goddamn button.
Wow.
Why I gotta fucking do it?
Y'all both there, nigga. What the fuck you want me to do?
What you talking to me for? Come on, man. Shut the fuck up.
He told you to do it. He wasn't gonna do it.